السلام عليكم. Management of vulval condition. دكتور فتح الرحمن الرشيد. UK National Guideline on the Management of Vulval Condition 2014. Objective. This guideline offers recommendation on the diagnostic test and treatment regimen needed for the effective management of the following vulval condition: vulval lesion sclerosis, vulval lesion planus, vulval eczema, vulval lesion simplex, vulval cirrhosis, vulval intraepithelial neoplasia, and vulval pain syndromes. Management. General advice for all vulval condition. Best meaning by multidisciplinary approach. Avoid contact with soap, shampoo, and bubble bath. Avoid tight fitting garment which may irritate the area. Avoid use of spermicidal lubricant condoms. Patient should be given detailed explanation of their condition. The patient's GP should be informed. STCI screening should be considered all patient. All patients should be assessed for sexual dysfunction. Vulval lesion sclerosis. Etiology. It is inflammatory dermatosis of unknown etiology. There is evidence to suggest that autoimmune factor may be involved in its pathogenesis. Clinical feature, symptom as itch, soreness, dyspareunia, urinary symptoms, other symptom, example, constipation, can be asymptomatic, but this is rare. Sign, pale, wide atrophic area affecting the vulva. Purpura is common. Fissuring, erosion, hyperkeratosis can occur. Change may be localized on in a figure of a distribution, including the perineal area. Loss of architecture may be manifest as loss of labia minora and/or midline fusion. The clitoral hood may be sealed over the clitoris, so it is in its period. Complication. Development of squamous cell carcinoma. Development of clitoral pseudocyst. Sexual dysfunction. And this is seizure. Diagnosis. Characteristic clinical appearance and histology of vulval biopsy. Management. Further investigation. Biopsy is mandatory if the diagnosis is uncertain. There is atypical feature of coexistent vulval intraepithelial neoplasia, squamous cell carcinoma is suspected. Investigation for autoimmune disease, skin swab, and patch testing. Treatment. General advice. Patient should be informed about the condition and given detailed information. Recommended regimen: ultrapotent topical steroid, example as clobetazole, propionate. Various regimen are used, one of the most common being daily used for the 1 month, alternate day for 1 month, twice weekly for 1 month, with review at 3 months. 30 grams of ultrapotent steroid should be last at least 3 months. ointment bases are much better to use on the anogenital skin. Alternative regimen: ultra-potent topical steroids with antibacterial and antifungal, example dermovets or generic equivalent, clobetazole with neomycin and nystatin, or alternative preparations that combat secondary infection such as fusibates creams may be appropriate if secondary infection is concerned. This should only be used for short period of time to clear infection. Pregnancy and breastfeeding: topical steroids are safe to use whilst pregnant or breastfeeding. Topical calcicein urine inhibitors are contraindicated whilst pregnant or breastfeeding. Retinoids are absolutely contraindicated during pregnancy and for at least 2 years before. They should be used with caution in female with of childbearing age. Follow up after 3 months to assess response to treatment. Stable disease should be reviewed annually. Patients should be informed that if there is any notice, the development of lump, sore area, change in symptom or change in appearance, they should promote medical review. Vulval lesion: planus. Etiology: it is inflammatory disorder with manifestation on skin, genital and oral mucous membrane. Clinical feature: symptom, itch, irritation, soreness, dyspareunia, urinary symptom, vaginal discharge, can be asymptomatic. Sign: the anogenital lesion may be divided in 2-3 main groups. Classical, typical papules will be found on the keratinized anogenital skins with or without striae on the inner aspect of the vulva. Hyperpigmentation frequently follows their resolution, particularly those with dark skins. These types of lesion planus may be asymptomatic. Hypertrophic: these lesions are relatively rare and can be difficult to diagnose. They particularly affect the perineum and perianal area, presenting as sickness, warty legs with maybe becomes ulcerated, infected, and painful. They do not appear to be accompanied by vaginal lesion. Erosive: the most common subtypes to cause vulval symptom. Complication: scarring, including vaginal sensitivity, development of squamous cell carcinoma. Diagnosis: characteristic clinical appearance, involvement of the vaginal exclude lesion sclerosis, skin change, immunopapulous disorder, and histology of vulval biopsy. Management: further investigation, biopsy, investigation for autoimmune disease, skin swab, and patch testing. Treatment: general advice: patient should be informed about the condition and given written information. Recommended regimen: ultra-potent topical steroid, example clobetazole, propionate. Maintenance treatment may be required and can be either by with weaker steroid preparation or less frequent use of potent steroid. Vaginal corticosteroids. Alternative regimen: ultra-potent topical steroid with antibacterial, antifungal, example and dermovets or generic equivalent, clobetazole with neomycin and nystatin, or alternative preparations that combat secondary infection such as fusibate cream may be appropriate if secondary infection is concern. This should be only be used for a short period of time to clear infection. And pregnant, topical steroids are safe to use while pregnant or breastfeeding. Topical calcineurin inhibitors are contraindicated while pregnant or breastfeeding. Retinoids are absolutely contraindicated during pregnancy. Follow up at 2 to 3 months to assess response to treatment. Active disease should be assessed as clinically required. Erosive lesion planners need long-term specialized follow-up. Stable disease should be reviewed annually. Vulval eczema, etiology, eczematous, allergic contact, and irritant contact. Clinical feature, symptom, vulval itch and soreness, sign, complication, secondary infection, diagnosis, clinical presentation, general examination of the skin, management, results investigation, patch testing, biopsy. Treatment, recommended treatment, avoid of precipitating factors, use of emollient soap substitute, and topical corticosteroid. Follow up as clinically required, long term follow up and psychological support may be needed. Lesion symbolic, pathology, categorized in 4 main groups: underlying dermatoses, atopic dermatitis, allergic contact dermatitis, superficial fungal infection, systematic condition causing pruritus, example renal failure, environmental factor, heat, sweat, trouble of clothing, and other written such as harsh skincare product, psychiatric disorder, anxiety, depression. Clinical feature, symptom, vulval itch, soreness, sign, lesion infiltrations, erosive and fissuring, excoriation as a result of scratching may be seen, so pubic hair is often lost in the area of scratching. Complication, secondary infection. Diagnosis, clinical presentation, history, and general examination of skin. Management, hazard investigation, screening for infection, example Staphylococcus aureus, Candida albicans, dermatological referral for consideration of patch testing, standard battery and medication, ferritin biopsy. Treatment, recommended treatment, avoid of precipitating factor, use of emollient soup, topical corticosteroids, a mildly anxiolytic antihistamine such as hydroxyzine or dexamethasone at night is helpful. The symptom of pruritus often respond fairly quickly to a topical steroid, but unless the lesion infiltration is resolved, cognitive behavioral therapy may be helpful if these are coexisting mental health issues. Follow up, mild disease as clinic required, severe disease 1 month then as required. Vulval cirrhosis. Cirrhosis is chronic inflammatory epidermal skin disease affecting approximately 2% of the general condition. Clinical feature, symptom, vulval itch, soreness and burning sensation. Sign, well demarcated tightly erythematous lugs, often symmetrical, frequently affected natal cleft, usually lack scaling due to maceration, fissuring. Complication may be worsened due to Kubner's effect or by irritation from urine, tightening, fitting close or sexual intercourse. Diagnosis, clinical presentation, general examination of skin and nails. Management, further investigation, sponge biopsy if the diagnosis is doubt. Treatment, recommended regimen, avoiding of irritating factors, use of emollient soap substitute, topical corticosteroid, coal tar preparation, vitamin D. Follow up, mild disease as clinical require, severe disease 1 month then as require. Other vulval dermatoses, vulval intraepithelial neoplasia, pathology. This is the vulval skin condition which may be become carcinogenous if left untreated. It is confirmed by histological diagnosis. In genitourinary medicine, clinical is the most common etiological agent is human papillomavirus. This is a known as usual types and is mainly associated with human papillomavirus 16. A second type, generally not human papillomavirus related, occurs in conjunction with lesion sclerosis or lesion planus, known as differentiated type. Clinical feature, symptom, lumps, pain and itch, irritation, asymptomatic, pain. Sign, clinical appearance is very variable. Raised white erythematous or pigmented lesion occur at, and this may be warty, moist, and red. Multifocal lesion are common. Complication, development of squamous cell carcinoma. Recurrence is common. Psychological consequence. Diagnosis, biopsy. Further investigation, ensure that cervical cytology remain up to date. All the patient of VN should be referred for up to date colposcopy to exclude CIN and VN. Treatment, recommended regimen, local incision. This is a treatment of choice for a small well circumcised lesion, and as it is has the lowest rate of recurrence on follow-up. Emmigrant white creams 5%, vulvectomy, alternative regimen, local destruction, and 5 fluorescein cream and supervision. Pregnancy and breastfeeding. Emigmoids and 5-fluorouracil cream are not licensed in pregnancy. Follow-up, close follow-up is mandatory. Vulval pain. Vulvodynia is characterized as generalized or localized, provoked and unprovoked, or mixture of the two. Localized provoked vulvodynia, etiology likely to be multifactorial. Clinical feature, symptom, vulval pain. Sign, focal tenderness, and there is no sign of acute inflammatory process. Complication, sexual dysfunction, psychological morbidity. Diagnosis, clinical diagnosis made on history and examination. Further investigation after exclusion of the other treatable causes, no further investigation is required. Treatment, The British Society for the Study of Vulval Disease recommended a multidisciplinary approach to the patient care. Alternative regimen, pain modulators, the benefit of drugs such as tricyclic antidepressant, surgery, modified vasectomy, follow-up, as clinical require long-term follow-up, and psychological support may be needed. Unprovoked vulvodynia etiology, unknown, clinical feature symptom, pain, sign, the vulva appear normal, complication, sexual dysfunction, psychological morbidity. Diagnosis, clinical diagnosis made on history and examination, having excluded other causes. Treatment, the British Society for Study of Vulval Disease recommended a multidisciplinary approach. Treatment resistant unprovoked vulvodynia may require referral to pain clinic. Recommended regimen, use of eliminate soap substitute, pain modifiers, alternative regimen, topical local anesthetic, cognitive behavioral therapy and psychotherapy, acupuncture follow-up as clinically required. Thank you.